Okay. So today's prophetic word is going to be forgiving offenses. Okay. Forgiving offenses. Okay. So we are going to be talking about Joseph. Okay. I just did a prophetic word maybe like a week ago. Okay. About Joseph. Okay. So we know all that happened to Joseph. Okay. His brothers were jealous of him. They sold him. They ultimately were going to kill him, but they eventually sold him. He was enslaved. He was in prison. He was lied on. Needless to say, Joseph went through a lot. But he comes out on top. And God shows him favor. God is continuously with him, and he sees Joseph through. Now Joseph is the head. Hallelujah. Now where we are at. Joseph is the head. He's over all of Egypt. And those who were his enemies have to come to him to buy food and grain to survive this famine. So those who were against him were his brothers. So his brothers come to Egypt. And they did not recognize Joseph. They're trying to buy food and grain from Joseph. And at first, they did not even recognize Joseph at this point. Hallelujah. So much time had passed. So Joseph takes them through, you know, a couple of tests. Until he basically, long story short, get all his brothers together. Now we are at the point when Joseph will reveal himself to his brothers. Because they did not know who he was. So let's see what happens. So in Genesis chapter 45, it says, then Joseph could not control himself before all those who stood by him. He cried, make everyone go out from me. So no one stayed with him when Joseph made himself known to his brothers. And he wept aloud so that the Egyptians heard it and the household of Pharaoh heard it. And Joseph said to his brothers, I am Joseph. Is my father still alive? But his brothers could not answer him, for they were dismayed at his presence. So Joseph said to his brothers, come near to me, please. And they came near, and he said, I am your brother Joseph, whom you sold into Egypt. And now, do not be distressed or angry with yourselves. Hold on. And now, do not be distressed or angry with yourselves because you sold me here. For God sent me before you to preserve life. For the famine has been in the land for 2 years, and there are yet 5 years in which there will be neither plowing nor harvest. And God sent me before you to preserve for you a remnant on earth and to keep alive for you many survivors. So it was not you who sent me here, but God. So it was not you who sent me here, but God. He has made me a father to Pharaoh and lord of all his house and ruler over all the land of Egypt. Hurry and go up to my father and say to him, thus says your son Joseph, God has made me lord of all Egypt. Come down to me. Do not tarry. You shall dwell in the land of Goshen, and you shall be near me, you and your children and your children's children and your flocks, your herd, and all that you have. There I will provide for you, for there are yet 5 years of famine to come, so that you and your household and all that you have do not come to poverty. And now your eyes see, and the eyes of my brother Benjamin see, that it is my mouth that speaks to you. You must tell my father all of my honor in Egypt and all that you have seen. Hurry and bring my father down here. Then he fell upon his brother Benjamin's neck and wept. And Benjamin went upon his neck, and he kissed all his brothers and wept upon them. After that, his brothers talked with him. When the report was heard in Pharaoh's house, Joseph's brothers had come. It pleased Pharaoh and his servants. And Pharaoh said to Joseph, "Say to your brothers, do this, load your beasts and go back to the land of Canaan. And take your father and your households and come to me. And I will give you the best of the land of Egypt. And you shall eat the fat of the land. And you, Joseph, are commanded to say, do this, take wagons from the land of Egypt for your little ones and for your wives and bring your father and come. Have no concern for your goods, for the best of all the land of Egypt is yours." The sons of Israel did so, and Joseph gave them wagons according to the command of Pharaoh, and gave them provisions for the journey. To each and all of them he gave a change of clothes, but to Benjamin he gave 300 shekels of silver and 5 changes of clothes. To his father he sent as follows: 10 donkeys loaded with the good things of Egypt, and 10 female donkeys loaded with grain, bread, and provision for his father on the journey. Then he sent his brothers away, and as they departed, he said to them, "Do not quarrel on the way." So they went up out of Egypt and came to the land of Canaan to their father Jacob, and they told him, "Joseph is still alive, and he is ruler over all the land of Egypt." And his heart became numb, for he did not believe them. But when they told him all the words of Joseph, which he had said to them, and when he saw the wagons that Joseph had sent to carry him, the spirit of their father Jacob revived. And Israel said, "It is enough. Joseph, my son, is still alive. I will go and see him before I die." So, God wants to talk to us about forgiving offenses. Forgiving offenses. What does this mean? We must learn to forgive those, hallelujah, who has offended us, who has done wrong to us, who has came up against us in whatever way it may have been. We have to understand that God works strategically, and he can work out all things for the good of those who love him. Before I made this prophetic word, God was talking to me about unforgiveness. Unforgiveness is like poison inside of your body. What does poison do? It kills. It kills. Unforgiveness, guilt, shame, fear, anger. It kills you. It eats at you. You being upset at someone else, or mad at someone else, or holding a grudge against someone else because of what they did to you, it's only killing you. It's only affecting you. It's only bringing you down. God is saying in this hour, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah, release. Release. Let it go. Thank you, Lord. God is saying, "I know what happened, but God said I brought you through, so let it go. Let it go." Yes, I say. God is saying, "I caused it to not prosper. Let it go." I hear you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. You came out on the other side of it. God brought you out. Yes, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Yes, I say, thank you, Father, that even though we do not understand, you worked it all out, Lord. You worked it all out, Lord. Cleanse us, Lord. Purge us, God. Hallelujah. Yes, I say, you're worthy, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Get the glory, Father, in the name of Jesus. Let it go. In the name of Jesus, let it go. If you don't know how, pray about it. Let it go. Yes, sir. Talk to God about it. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.